Hello students, today in this video I will explain you exercise number 30. Question number 1. Identify which of the following division forms are terminating decimal and which are non-terminating. First part, 5 upon 8 is given. So we have to check whether this is a terminating decimal or non-terminating. So for this what you have to do? First of all, we will divide 5 with a table of 8. Here we have to show the division in a pair work. This 8 we have to write outside. Dividend is 5. 5 we will write inside. With a table of 8, 5 is not divisible. So what we will do? We have to take decimal. First of all, we have to take decimal in the answer. So when we will take decimal in the answer, we have to add here 0. Now this is 50. 8 6 is 48. On subtracting it, we will get remainder 2. Now decimal is already there in the answer. We can add 1 0 here. 8 table we will read again. 8 2 is 16. Remainder will be 4. Now decimal is already in the answer, so we can add 1 0 in this step also. 8 5 is 40. So finally we are getting the remainder 0. So here we got remainder is 0. So such division in which we are getting remainder 0, such division is, such decimal numbers are known as terminating decimal. So you have to write answer of 5 upon 8 is 0.625, and after that you have to write it is terminating decimal. So like this you have to do part number 1. Now see another part, part number 3. First question, third part. So we have to divide them first. With a table of 25, we have to divide 19. It is not possible to divide 19. So what we will do? In the answer, we have to take decimal and we will add here 0. Now this is 190. 25, 4 is 100. 25, 7 ja we will do. Then answer will be 175. Now on subtracting these two numbers, we will get 10 minus 5, 5. 8 minus 7 will be 1. So 15 is the remainder, and here in the answer already one decimal is there, so because of this decimal in this step we can add here 0. So now this became 150. 25 6 is 150. On subtracting them, remainder is 0. So again in this part also we are getting remainder 0. That means division work is over. Such decimal numbers are known as terminating decimal. So first of all we will write the answer of this. Answer of this is 0.76, and after that we will write it is terminating decimal. Now see another part. Part number 6th. Sixth part. Sixth part is 3.75 divided by 9. So we have to divide 3.75 with a table of 9. So here before the decimal 3 is written. So in a table of 9, 3 is not coming. So what we will do? 9 0 ja 0. On subtracting it, remainder we will get 3. Now when we will bring this 7 down, before this 7 decimal is there. So in the answer also we have to put decimal. Now this is 37. 9 4 ja 36. Remainder is 1. This 5 we will bring down. So this will become 15. 9 1 ja 9. On subtracting it, remainder will be 6. Answer here decimal we are already having in the answer, so we will add here 10. Now this is 60. 9 table we will read. 9 7 ja 63. 9 6 ja we will take. 9 6 ja 54. After that, here we are getting again remainder 6. So this 6 will become 60 because in the answer we had taken decimal already. Now we can add here 0. So this is 60. Earlier also in the previous step we are having 60. Now also we are having 60. Again when we will divide with the table of 9, answer will remain same. 9, 6, 54. So here what you will observe, remainder is coming same again and again. Here also remainder was 6, here also remainder was 6. Now again also we got same remainder. That means this division will not get over. So finally we will write here, on dividing these two we are getting answer 0.4166, but this answer is not over. So that means we have to put here so on. So on means this answer is not over, it will go on further. Here also we will put so on. So such numbers are known as non-terminating decimal. Non-terminating decimal. So like this, you have to do question number first. Now all of you see question number second. Express the following fraction as recurring decimal. So we have to write as a recurring decimal. First part, 1/3. So first of all we have to show the division. With a table of 3 we have to divide 1. So this 1 is not divisible by 3. So we have to take decimal and we will add here 0. 3 3 is 9. On subtracting it, remainder is 1. Decimal is already there in the answer, so 0 we will take ourselves. 3 3 is 9. Again remainder is 1. So here what you are observing, every time we are getting same remainder. That means this answer will keep on coming like this only. It will repeat. So we will write it here 0.33 and so on. It will goes on repeating. Such answers are known as recurring decimal. Recurring means repeat hona. So here what you, which number is repeating? 3 is repeating, that's why on 3 we have to put bar. Bar means repeat. So 3 is coming again and again, that's why we are putting bar on 3. So this is your final answer of part number first. Now see another part, part number fourth. Fourth part, 1/11. So first of all we have to divide with a table of 11. 1 is not divisible by 11, so we will take decimal in the answer and we will take here 0. 10 is not divisible by 11. Again this number is smaller, so what we have to do, 10 we have to add in the answer and one more 0 we will take here. So first 0 we have taken with this decimal. After that one more 0 we need, so in the answer also we have to put 10 and here also we will use 10. Now this is 100. 11 9 ja 99. On subtracting it, remainder is 1. Now 1 is not divisible by 11, this is the remainder. Point is already there in the answer. This point, because of this point we will add here 10. This is 10. 10 is not divisible by 11, so what we will do, again we will take 10 here and in this 10 also we will add 10. So in the answer also we are adding 0 and here in the remainder also we are adding 10. Now this is 100 again, as we got 100 earlier, now again also we are getting 100. 11 9 ja 99. Again remainder is 1. So here what you are observing, again and again remainder is coming same, 1 1. So what you will do now, this answer will keep on coming like that only. So this is non-terminating decimal, and here you will observe that our answer on dividing is 0.0909 and so on. So here two numbers are repeating. Which two numbers are repeating? 09. So what we have to do, we will write 0.09 and on 09 we will use bar. Why we will use bar? Because this 09 is repeating again and again. So that's why this 09 we have to use here bar.
So like this, you have to do
question number 4.
Now all of us see fifth part.
Fifth part, 5 divided by 7. So here we will show the division. 7 we have to take outside, 5 we have to take inside. 5 is not divisible by 7, so what we will do here, in the answer we will take decimal and we will add here 0. 7 is 49. On subtracting it, remainder is 1. Decimal is already there in the answer, so we will add here 1 0. 7 1 ja 7, remainder is 3. In the answer decimal is there, so we will take 1 0 from our side. 7 4 ja 28, remainder is 2. Decimal is there in the answer, so 1 0 we will add here. 7 2 ja 14. On subtracting it, remainder is 6. Decimal is there in the answer, so we will take 10 from our side. 7 ja 49, 7 8 ja 56. On subtracting it, remainder is 4. Decimal is there in the answer, so one more 0 we will take here in the denominator, in the remainder. 7 5 ja 35. On subtracting it, we are getting remainder 5. So if we will take 10 here, this will become 50. And you will observe that here also it is written 50. So this remainder, if we will proceed further, what we will observe? We will observe that all this whole work will come again. That means this full answer will repeat again. So what we will do? Here we will put so on dividing these numbers, we are getting 0.714285, and after that remainder is 5. This 5 will become 50 and this work will come again. So that means all these values will repeat again. So these all values are repeating values, so we have to put here bar. So like this, we have to do part number 5. Now see another part, part number 7. Seventh part. So we have to divide it with a table of 11. 0.08. So in the beginning itself we are getting one decimal here. So in the answer also we have to put decimal. Now this is the first number. First number is 0. 11 0 ja 0. On subtracting it, remainder is 0. 8 we will bring down. 8 is not divisible by 11. So what we will do? We will take 11 0 ja 0. On subtracting it, remainder is 8. Or you can do one more thing. This 0 you can add here and directly you can take here 10. That also you can do. Or 11 0 ja 0 we can do. Then we will get remainder 8. Now what we will do? Because of this decimal, we will take here 10. Now this is 80. 11 7 ja 77. On subtracting it, we will get the remainder 3. Now decimal is there, so in the remainder we can add 0. This is 30 now. 11 2 ja 22. On subtracting, remainder we will get 8. Decimal is already there in the answer, so we will add 10 in the remainder. This is 80. 11 7 ja 77. Remainder is 3. Now we will add 10. This is 30 now. 11 2 ja 22. Again remainder is 8. So here we will observe that remainder are coming same again and again. 8 8 8. So now what we will do? This is a non-terminating decimal. So we will write it. On dividing it, we are getting 0.007272 and so on. But here you will observe that 72 is repeating. This is a repeating number. So what we will do? 0.0072 and on 72 we will put bar because this bar represent that this is a repeating number. So 72 is coming again and again, that's why we will put bar on 72. So like this you have to do question number 2nd, part number 7. Now rest of the parts you have to do by yourself, all parts are same, you have to follow this method. Now see question number 3rd. Third question. Express the following recurring decimal as fraction. So here in the question, recurring decimal are given. Third question, part number 1st. 0.3 and on 3 dot is written. This dot means bar only. Sometimes dots are not visible in the book also. Very light color dot is given. So it's better in place of dot, you just put bar. So question is 0.3 bar. So this is a recurring decimal. We have to write as a fraction. Fraction means in the upon form we have to write. So first of all, we will assume that this is the value of x. Let's say this is the value of x. Now we will write the meaning of this bar. What is the meaning of this bar? Meaning of this bar is 3 is a repeating number. 3 is coming again and again. How many times it will come? Infinite number of times. So only 4 times we have written, after that we have put so on. This is your equation number 1. Now in the next step what we will do, we will check on how many digits bar is there. Only on single digit bar is there. So whenever bar will be on a single digit, then you have to multiply by 10. So what we will do, we will multiply by 10 on both sides. Now both the sides we have to multiply by 10. On left hand x is written, so 10 into x will be 10x. On right hand 0.3333 and so on. So on means this 3 will keep on coming like that only. So when we will multiply by 10 on right hand, so on multiplying with 10, this decimal will shift one place right side. Why it will shift one place right side? Because whenever we have to multiply any number by 10, how many zeros are coming here? Only one zero is coming. So when we will multiply with 10, this point will shift one place right. And when we will divide with 10, then on dividing by 10, this point will shift to one place left. So on dividing it, decimal will shift to left place, and on multiplying it, decimal will shift to right place. So here we are multiplying by 10, and in 10 only one zero is there, so this point will shift to one place right side. So this will become 0.3333. This point will come here, and after that 333. How many times we will write? We will write it 4 times only, because in the previous step also we are writing our answer of up to 4 decimal place. After the point, how many digits we had written? 4 digits we had written, but these are infinite numbers. 0.3333 and so on. This is a recurring decimal. That means 3 will come infinite number of times, but we are showing only 4 times. So here also what we will do, after the decimal, how many times 3 will come? It is a recurring decimal only. It will come infinite number of times, but we will show it 4 times, because in the previous step 4 decimal place we are taken. In this step also we will take our answer up to 4 decimal place. So this is your equation number 2nd. Now this equation is greater because in this 10x is written, and this equation is smaller because it is in this 1x is written. So we have to subtract equation 1 from 2. We have to subtract equation 1 from 2, and subtract rule is that the equation which is written after from which equation is written? Second equation. So that equation we have to write in the beginning. First we will write the second equation. And then in the next line we will write the first equation. 1x. Under the equal sign, we have to put equal. 1x equals 0.3333 and so on. Here also so on. So when we will subtract both the sides, left side as well as right side, 10x minus 1x will become 9x. This will become 0.3. So here we are getting 9x is equal to 3. So x is equal to 3 upon 9. On dividing it with the table of 3, we will get the final answer 1 upon 3. So here we got the fraction. So like this, you have to do question number 3rd, first part. Now see another part, part number 3rd. Third part. Recurring decimal is given 0.13 and on 3 dot is there, but I told you dot, no need to write dot. In place of dot we will put bar, because sometimes dots is not visible in the answer. So that's why it's better you put bar. So on which number we have to put bar? On 3 we have to put bar. Now what we will do, we will assume, let's say this recurring decimal is the value of x. X is equal to 0.13 bar. Now we will write the meaning of this recurring decimal. The meaning of this recurring decimal is that this 3 is having bar, that means this 3 is repeating again and again. So this is your equation number 1. Now in the next step, what we will do? We will check how many digit bar is coming. On how many digits bar is there? Only on a single digit bar is there, that means we have to multiply by 10. If bar will be on 2 digits, then we have to multiply with 100, that means 2 zeros we have to take. Since bar is on single digit, so we will take how many zeros? Only 1 zero, that means we have to multiply both sides by 10. So on left hand it is 1x. When we will multiply with 10, it will become 10x. When we will multiply this number with 10, then I told you in the previous question, on multiplying the decimal will shift to right hand. So in the 10, how many zero are there? Only 1 zero. So this point will shift to one place right, that means we will write here. So this will become 1.3333 and so on. This is a recurring decimal, that means 3 will come on, keep on coming like that only. So after the decimal, how many digits I had written here in the equation number 1? After the decimal, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in this also, after the decimal, you have to write 5 digits. 1, 2, 3, 4, one more you can write 3. Why? Because this is a recurring decimal. And in this, how many 3's will be there? Infinite number of 3 will be there. So here we are showing only 5 digits after the decimal. Now, this is your equation number 2nd. You have to check which equation is greater. Here it is 10x, that means second equation is greater. So we have to subtract equation smaller one from equation larger one. And the rule is that the equation which is written after from, that we have to write first. So first of all, you will write this second equation. 10x equal to 1.33333, so on. Second equation is over. Now we will write first equation. 1x is equal to 0.13333 and so on. We have to subtract, so we will put minus sign. 10x minus minus will become 9x. 3 minus 3 is 0. 0.002.1 minus 0 will be 1. So here we are getting 9x is equal to 1.2. These 0 do not have any value, so we will leave it. X is equal to 1.2 upon 9. Point we will remove, then we will take here 0 in the denominator. Now these two will get cancelled with a table of 3. 3, 4 ja 12, 3, 30 ja. So final answer we are getting here is 4 upon 30. So this is the fraction. Like this you have to do question number 3rd, part number 3rd. We can cancel it further. ये अभी और कैंसिल हो सकते हैं विद अ टेबल ऑफ टू, टू टू जा फोर, टू फिफ्टीन जा, सो दिस इज योर फाइनल आंसर। सो इन प्लेस ऑफ फोर अपॉन थर्टी वी विल राइट आवर फाइनल आंसर इज टू अपॉन फिफ्टीन। नाउ सी अनदर पार्ट, पार्ट नंबर फोर। थर्ड क्वेश्चन फोर्थ पार्ट। जीरो पॉइंट वन सेवन एंड बार इज देयर ऑन बोथ द नंबर्स वन एज वेल एज ऑन सेवन। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल एज्यूम दैट दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स। नाउ वी विल राइट द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस रिकरिंग डेसिमल। दिस इज 0.17, बार इज ऑन बोथ द नंबर, सो बोथ नंबर्स आर रिपीटिंग 17 and so on. This is your equation number 1. Now next step is you have to check how many digits are repeating. How many digits are repeating here? 2. That means we have to multiply by 100. Since here 2 digits are repeating, we will multiply both sides by 100. So left hand, when we will multiply with 100, it will become 100x. On right hand, when we will multiply with 100, in 100 how many zeros are there? 2. So on multiplying, decimal will shift to right hand. How many place it will shift to right hand? 2 place. That means from here it will come here. So this will be 17.1717 and so on. This is your equation number 2. But I told you, in first equation, after the decimal how many digits are written? 6. So in this also we will write how many digits? 6 digits. So 17, one more 17 we will take. It is our choice because this is a recurring number. Recurring means 17 will come how many times? Infinite number of times. But how many times we will write? In here we are showing it up to 6 place of decimal. So here in this also we will show the, our work up to 6 place of decimal. So now both are up to 6 place. Now we will subtract equation 1 from second. From ke baad second hai, so this second equation we will write first. First equation we will write downside. Subtract sign we will put. 100x minus 1x will be 99x. On subtracting it we will get 17.00. X answer is 17/99. So this is your final answer of this part number 4. So now this exercise is over. You all have to finish this exercise by yourself now. Remaining questions are same as I had explained you. So in case if you are having any doubt, then you can put the comment in a comment box. I will explain you in the next video.